are joining us now on the news to further discuss the security situation, particularly in Sokoto State, is Wilson Inalebu, a former Assistant Inspector General of Police, and he joins us via telephone. Thank you very much, Mr. Wilson, for joining us on News Now. Now, what do you make of the situation, the current situation in Sokoto State? Is that state gradually becoming the hotbed of banditry in the Northwest?
Well, I think the entire Northwest appears is under attack by bandits and kidnappers. So any watcher of the security, evolving security situation in the country should not be too surprised at what is happening in Sokoto State. Because when you talk of Zamfara, Zamfara was part of Sokoto and even part of Kebbi, the Yangebe attack where some students were kidnapped in Kebbi State. So, I think the situation in that region is very similar. So one shouldn't be too surprised, but it calls for action, it calls for synergy among various security stakeholders, especially the security agencies and the citizens. So I don't think I'm too surprised, because it should have been anticipated by the elites.
I mean, you just said it should have been anticipated. Is it because Sokoto State is bordering states like Zamfara, or is it just because it's a northwest situation? Because of all the states in that region, we would say that for a while now, we would say that Sokoto was a bit relatively peaceful.
Yeah, but there is a lot of heat that is being brought from there, from Zamfara and Katsina State. Therefore, you expect there will be a push, a spillover to other neighboring states. Mm-hmm. Because these people look for sub-targets. And because of the intense security operations ongoing in Zamfara State, where telecommunications and other things have been caught, you expect that where they think this is not happening. Because what are they looking for, really? They, first of all, they're looking for money, they're looking for relevance, and they want to create a general state of anomaly. And wherever they can do it, they will do it. So if you are in Sokoto and you have those attacks, if when your neighbor's house is on fire, it's time for you to be watchful. So it's not, it's just the same mentality, the same thing that is pushing them. Therefore, what it calls for? It calls for collaboration between the police, other security agencies, and the public. Because these attacks come very speedily. They are surprise attacks. So what do you do? We must begin to look at getting the public to support, getting information, intelligence, getting actionable intelligence so that you can distort these attacks, so that you can stand their onclave, make it difficult for them. And if you do not have adequate intelligence to intercept them and they hide their plan, but the moment they come out, even if you kill 100 of them and they kill 2, 3, 4 people, it's already too bad. Therefore, there must be proactivity in dealing with this situation, because it's a situation of element of surprise, element of speed. They just come, create general state of insecurity, general state of fear. And so what do? Get the public, get adequate information, get the food sellers, get the Okada riders, and train the vigilante. The security agencies must now bring them in as more or less partner and train them so that they can work in close collaboration with relevant security agencies, especially indeed. The police. So you've got to do that. When you do that, wherever they are, even if in the market, anywhere you have a congregation, a large gathering of people, marketplaces, big ceremonies, your brain should just tell you that these mad guys, this criminal element, could come to just make a statement.
Exactly, Mr. Wilson Inalebo, I'm afraid we just actually have to leave it here. But thank you very much for your brilliant contributions on the news. Wilson Inalebo, former Assistant Inspector General of Police, there speaking to us on the security situation in Sokoto State.